Welcome to my cello studio. I am Jeff Krieger, and this is a video on navigating the landscape of the fingerboard. Think about it. String players have an amazing skill of locating the notes on the fingerboard, seemingly out of nowhere. As musicians, we really take for granted how this skill dazzles audiences. The more you know about fingerboard geography, the easier and more fun you'll have playing the cello. First, it is important to review reasons why we use positions to play a piece. The positions allow us to eliminate open strings that stick out as non-vibrated notes, disrupting the flow of a beautiful melody. Here are two versions of a melody, the first with open strings. Now a second version without open strings, using positions. The positions allow us to play more advanced repertoire in keys that may not permit open strings. Also, positions allow us to keep to our particular character of a string. For example, the D string's beautiful muted quality, especially in the fourth to seventh positions. Here are four measures from Schubert's Berceuse, all on the D string. These are very good artistic reasons to be completely comfortable with all of the positions and all of the possible fingering combinations. Often, there is more than one available fingering for a melody to choose. Eventually, you will know enough about the fingerboard and how to choose good fingerings on your own. You can pause this video at any time to have a closer look at the tools that are mentioned, or to practice a suggested strategy. The links to the tools are in the text below this video. Even though you no longer have tapes on your cello, it is helpful to continue to visualize this grid, helping you to find note locations with better accuracy. By now, you should know your note names and the distances between notes, whole or half steps. If you need to brush up on that, please review using the online note identification tool. Now, in order to demonstrate the more challenging fingerboard geography, I will be referring to particular measures in Humoreske by Antonin Dvorak, found in Suzuki Volume 3. When there are measures with two sets of possible fingerings, we will follow the better set of fingerings below the staff. Humoreske uses fingerings that eliminate open strings, position work of just about all of the seven neck positions, as well as alternating three hand positions and finger substitutions. If you learn Humoreske, or you know it already, you will know a lot of cello. To begin, at the end of measure 7 of Humoreske, the shift to the A in second position with the fourth finger on the D string, followed by the D across the string on the G string, not only eliminates open strings, but gets you ready for the first finger on F sharp in second position on the D string in measure 9. This move means it will be easier to get to the high F sharp in third position with the fourth finger in measure 9. In measures 9 through 11, it is important for accuracy to know the distance between notes while alternating between the different hand positions. In measure 9, beginning with the F sharp on the second eighth note, the hand is open for two whole steps between F sharp and D. Closed in measure 10 for 1.5 steps between D and B, and open again in measure 11 for two whole steps between G and B. There are also finger substitutions on unison notes over the bar lines to help with accuracy of pitch in these measures. Moving on to measure 23, in order to find the F natural accurately, it is helpful to know where the fingers are placed in relation to other positions and the distances of the intervals across the string. You might think of this hand position either as high third position, beginning with the first finger on G sharp, or 1/2 step back from fourth position. What are the distances of the notes across the string in this measure? The answer is half steps. Also, knowing the sound of this jazzy F natural is very helpful. Have you listened to the recording enough to hear these notes in your head? Now, in measure 32, an accurate finger substitution from the open D at the end of the measure before to the unison D third finger in third position on the G string is critical to set up the next line of challenging position changes. Drill this until precise. In measures 33 through 36, there are 5 position changes, as well as alternating hand positions. Knowing the distances between the first and fourth finger is key to accuracy. Are they 2 whole or 1.5 steps? Practice this line under tempo, testing pitch accuracy often with open strings. Notice that there are many D's and C's to match in these measures. Practice keeping those notes in your ear and that they match pitch. In measures 37 through 40, there are 5 position changes, alternating hand positions, and a 7th position high C. For the high C, it helps to know that your first finger falls on the A harmonic. What are the distances between the notes in measure 40? The answer is 1.5 steps. It is helpful to practice this challenging measure separate bow, as well as practicing the accompanying preliminary exercise 2-D. After you become familiar with these fingerboard challenges in Humoreske, try using the memorize, look, and listen strategy under tempo. This strategy of looking at fingerboard placement and listening at the same time and your new knowledge of the fingerboard will help to raise the level of pitch accuracy. The body memorizes fingerboard placement regardless of how correct. Remember to keep track of pitch along the way by testing with open strings, unisons, octaves, and harmonics. I have outlined the technical leaps to conquer in Humoreske. Here are the main points from this video to follow. Know the interval distances between notes, whole or half steps, in order to determine the correct hand position. Monitor pitch with open strings and harmonics. Use what you have heard from recordings. Look at the fingerboard. Humoreske is a great piece and well worth the effort. You will find fun projects to try in the text below this video after the tool links. So this is the end of the video on navigating the landscape of the fingerboard. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to watch the other videos in this collection and come back often to listen again and check your progress.